Over the past 20 years, the global economy, food systems, and the nutritional status of populations around the world have been changing. While there's been a notable drop in the numbers of those who go to bed hungry, unacceptably high levels of malnutrition persist. Around half the global population currently suffers from some form of malnutrition. Malnutrition encompasses more than undernutrition, micronutrient deficiencies, or the lack of the right combination of nutrients, including minerals, vitamins, and trace elements, have a profound effect on our lives. And then there's the growing problem of obesity.
There is enough food in the world right now to feed everybody, but millions are still going hungry. Many aren't getting the right mix of foods to be healthy, and growing numbers in all parts of the world are consuming too much.
Let's take a look at some of the numbers. As many as 805 million people around the world are currently chronically undernourished. That's one in every nine persons. It's a sharp decrease, around 21% compared with 20 years ago. But these numbers are still too high. Of child deaths, around 45% are linked to undernutrition. Some 161 million children are stunted due to chronic undernutrition. But in contrast lies another problem, obesity. 500 million adults were obese in 2013. Malnutrition, in all its forms, from undernutrition to micronutrient deficiencies and overnutrition, is a complex issue. A number of factors have contributed to the current picture. The economic downturn has pushed food prices up. Natural disasters and climatic shocks have weakened food systems. Many countries don't have access to technology and investment needed to build resilience. Lifestyle and income changes, plus increased urbanization, have created new challenges. As diets rich in foods that are high in sugar, fat, and salt help fuel obesity. There's also a positive side to this picture. In the last two decades, millions more are eating better and have been able to provide for their nutritional needs. For us to improve diets and raise levels of nutrition internationally, we need coherent policies.
Now we have commitment. Commitment by itself is not enough. We really need to move further. Change that commitment into action, and action into impact and results. And that's where we really need to go. We want, in the next few years, we want to really reduce the problem of stunting, the problem of malnutrition, to zero. In fact, we want it to be zero because every life matters. You know, nobody should be left behind. No country should be left behind.
Global problems need global solutions. Let's meet the challenges together and act decisively to beat the nutrition challenges of today. Investing now isn't only a moral imperative, it makes economic sense because it will cut healthcare costs and promote development in this country and in yours.
It requires integrated policies involving all relevant sectors, including food, agriculture, health, education, and many others.
The challenges at the policy intersection of agriculture, nutrition, and health are already enormously complex. On current trends, this complexity will only grow. For all of these reasons, the coming International Conference on Nutrition will need to be a watershed event.